Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome back to another ATP video. In today's video we'll be talking about an important organism that is often forgotten. It can affect many systems in the body, but luckily we can reduce its ways of transmission and treat it. It's usually linked to raw milk or unpasteurized dairy products. We will talk about Brucella. Without further delay, let's begin. Brucella is an aerobic gram-negative coccobacillus. It's non-encapsulated, non-motile, so it doesn't move, facultatively intracellular, which means they can survive inside and outside host cells. Its urea is positive, and in addition to that, many Brucella species are oxidase, catalase, and superoxide dismutase positive. Brucella can stay alive even when being in extreme conditions of both temperature and pH. Also, it can infect macrophages and stay alive inside them. Now in the lab, it can be grown in charcoal yeast extract agar, which also needs to contain cysteine and iron. Remember that these four organisms also need the same agar to be cultured: Brucella, Francisella, Legionella, and Pasteurella. So you can say that all the difficult and weird names are clumped together when it comes to this agar. Now to diagnose Brucella, we can take blood or bone marrow samples for culturing. It's worth mentioning that Brucella is considered a slow-growing organism, so it requires prolonged incubation that can reach up to 6 weeks, although newer techniques are becoming more readily available to get quicker results. Other serological tests are available to diagnose Brucella, which include serum agglutination test, SAT for short, and ELISA, which is enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. Moreover, in cases of Brucella arthritis, the WBC count is usually less than 50,000 and is of lymphocytic predominance, as opposed to bacterial septic arthritis, where the WBC count is more than 50,000 and is of neutrophilic predominance. Now, how is Brucella transmitted? Brucella can cause brucellosis, which is considered a zoonotic infection. Zoonoses are the infections that are transmitted to humans from organisms that are not humans, specifically animals in the case of Brucella. Now, how does that happen? It can happen through the consumption of animal products such as their meat, unpasteurized milk, or direct contact with infected animals. Animals can serve as a reservoir, and different animals are known to carry different species of Brucella. Lastly, human-to-human transmission is considered extremely rare, so it doesn't really happen. Now for the million-dollar question. What is Brucella known for? Tough question, but fear not, with ATP, we'll simplify everything. The answer is brucellosis, or al-hamma al-maltiya in Arabic. Brucellosis also has many names, which includes Malta, undulant, or Mediterranean fever. Patients can last up to 4 weeks before showing symptoms of brucellosis. This is also known as the incubation period. Then the symptoms appear, which vary from patient to another, and they include fever, which is undulant because it's cyclical, which means it goes up and down frequently, headache, arthralgia, which means joint pain, night sweats, anorexia and fatigue, and hepatomegaly. It classically can be described to cause foul-smelling perspiration. It can also affect lymph nodes, and that results in non-caseating granulomas. Other less common but more serious complications include arthritis, orchitis, spondylitis, osteomyelitis, neurobrucellosis, or endocarditis. That's a lot of itis for you, huh? Although these symptoms are not specific, physicians should have a low threshold for suspecting Brucella in endemic areas and in the presence of history of animal product consumption or direct contact with animals, so if a patient lives in a farm, for instance. It can also affect fetuses and result in sepsis, low birth weight, hepatosplenomegaly, and or respiratory difficulties. Finally, for the treatment and prevention. As for prevention, we can follow certain measures to reduce the risk of transmission. 1. Control disease spread in areas known to have high rates of brucellosis. 2. Milk pasteurization. And 3. Raising awareness among the public. As for the treatment, generally speaking, we can use doxycycline plus rifampin or streptomycin to treat brucellosis. Alright, to sum up, Brucella is an aerobic gram-negative coccobacilli that has many enzymes which adds to its virulence. It can cause brucellosis, which is a zoonotic infection, leading to a variety of non-specific symptoms. Brucella can cause serious complications like osteomyelitis, neurobrucellosis, or even death if not appropriately treated. Milk pasteurization can reduce its transmission. And lastly, we treat it by using doxycycline plus rifampin or streptomycin. And that's it for Brucella. We hope you found it beneficial. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to receive our latest explanations. And as always, thanks for watching.